Hello everybody. So we come to the last topic of the fuel units. In this lecture, we will be dealing with the liquefied petroleum gas, the compressed natural gas, biomass and bioenergy, and finally the biogas. So this slide is showing the liquefied petroleum gas. Liquefied petroleum gas is in fact a liquid fuel, and it is mainly derived from crude oil and natural gas. Now its major composition is propane, butane, isopropane, isobutane. In fact, it is hydrocarbons, that means consisting of carbon and hydrogen. So we know that in the earlier slides we have discussed that a fuel having more number of carbon and hydrogen and less of the inorganic elements, the higher will be the calorific value. And also because of the minimum amount of inorganic elements present in the fuels, the ash content will be consequently lower. So in the liquefied petroleum gas is consisting of only hydrocarbons. So because it is derived from crude oil and natural gas, hydrocarbons means carbon and hydrogen, and this is the LPG hydrocarbons. They burn without leaving any residue, means that the amount of inorganic elements is minimum. Hence the LPG hydrocarbons, they are burning with minimum residue, and because their constituents are hydrocarbons only, the LPG hydrocarbons, they burn with a higher calorific value than any other gaseous fuels. We know that a gaseous fuel has the highest calorific value as compared to solid and liquid fuels. Now the calorific value of LPG is 7 times higher than the coal gas and 3 times higher than natural gas. So LPG is preferred because of its higher calorific value, and also because of minimum emissions to the environment. That means it's an environmentally friendly fuel with minimum sulfur content and lowest black carbon emission. So the LPG that is used for household purposes, that is for cooking purposes, is made of isopropane and isobutane, or it can be a combination of the two. Now why we are saying it is liquefied petroleum gas? So why we are saying liquefied? Because LPG is very easily converted to a liquid state. Now you will be asking the question that why LPG has to be converted to a liquid state, because of its easy controllable nature. Because the fuel, when it is converted to a liquid state, it is stored and transported easily as compared to that of a gaseous fuel. Now what are the advantages of using LPG as a fuel? LPG hydrocarbons, first of all, because they are having minimum amount of inorganic elements, they produce minimum burn toxic or smoke emissions. Hence they are environmentally friendly. Also it is having minimum sulfur content. So it is having less of health hazards even in the case of a leakage. And because of its environmental friendliness, and because it is requiring minimum maintenance, hence this is a more favorable or more preferred fuel. Now LPG is suitable only for engines working under high compression ratio, easily stored in massive tanks. LPG is many times used as a fuel source in remote areas where the obtaining other products via pipeline or transport would be impossible. So hence LPG is preferred. In fact, LPG is preferred as a household purpose fuel because of its environmental friendliness, and because of its less toxic emissions, and because of its higher calorific value. Now what is compressed natural gas or CNG? So CNG is a gaseous fuel. It is made of hydrocarbons, and its composition is mainly methane only, and it can be, because it's methane, that means its calorific value is very high, and it can easily be replaced or used in place of petrol, diesel and LPG. Now its composition is methane, and it is compressed to less than 1% of the volume that it occupies at standard atmospheric pressure. Now CNG is stored in cylindrical or spherical containers at very high atmospheric pressure of 20 to 25 megapascal. Now, what are the advantages of using CNG? The combustion of CNG produces fewer undesirable gases, unburnt hydrocarbons, carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxides, and particulate matter as compared to petroleum-derived fuels. So, due to its lower carbon dioxide emission, switching to CNG can help reduce greenhouse gas emissions, hence it is environmentally safe. Now, it is safer than other fuels in the event of a leak or spill because CNG is lighter than air and disperses quickly when released. Now, being a gaseous fuel, its calorific value is very high as compared to that of liquids or solid fuels. Hence, its efficiency is also very high. Now, CNG does not contain lead and does not react with metals. Hence, the maintenance cost of engines of transportation vehicles is increased. The drawback is that being a gaseous fuel, CNG occupies greater amount of space for fuel storage than liquid fuels like petrol, diesel, or conventional gasoline. Now let us come to biomass and bioenergy. Now what is biomass? Biomass, the word biomass means that it is derived from biological matter, hence it is an organic material, and the source of this organic material is plants, animals, and the energy that is derived from biomass is a renewable source of energy. Now the biomass contains the energy from that is stored from the sun. The plants absorb the sun's energy in the process called photosynthesis, and when the biomass is burned, the chemical energy of the biomass is converted to the heat energy or the light energy. And biomass can be burned directly, or they can be converted to liquid fuels or the biogas that can be burnt as fuels. So examples of biomass and their uses for energy are the wood and wood processing waste burned to heat buildings to produce process heat in industry and to generate electricity. Now, agricultural crops and waste materials, they can be burnt as fuel or they can be converted to liquid biofuels. Now, similarly, the food, yard, wood waste in garbage, they can be burnt to generate electricity in power plants or they can be converted to biogas in landfills. And finally, the animal manure and human sewage, they can be converted to biogas, which can be burnt as a fuel. Now, what is a biogas? Biogas is in fact the degradation of organic matter by the action of the microorganisms like bacteria or fungi in the absence of oxygen. That means the conditions maintained has to be anaerobic. Now, the cheapest and easily obtainable biogas is obtained from the cow dung. It is known as gobar gas. Now, the formation of gobar gas is carried out in steel chambers. You can see that this is a steel chamber. It is called as digester, and it is placed above or below the ground, into which the slurry made by mixing equal parts of fresh cow dung and water is poured into the digester. Now, the anaerobic bacteria present in the dung digest this sludge, generating carbon dioxide and methane. So, biogas, the composition of biogas is carbon dioxide and methane, and the optimum temperature for the digestion process is 34 to 48 degrees centigrade, and the gas is collected in steel gas holder placed on top of the digestion tank. Now, the average composition of the gobar gas is methane, that is 55%, hydrogen 7%, carbon dioxide 35%, nitrogen 2.6%, and some trace amounts of H2S. So that means biogas is basically carbon dioxide and methane, and its gross calorific value is 1200 kilocalories per meter cubed. So what are the advantages of gobar gas? It has been found that 4.25 kg of fresh cow dung, or in fact 1 kg of dry cow dung, gives 160 liter of gobar gas, which can supply 188 kilocalories of heat. On the other hand, 1 kg of dry dung can give 23.4 kilocalories of effective heat. Thus, gobar gas production is very economical. The gas has all the advantages of gaseous fuel, like flexibility, optimum utilization, cleanliness, absence of dust, smoke, dirt, etc. Now, it does not emit any poisonous gas like carbon monoxide, and it has a flame temperature of about 540 degrees centigrade, and it also produces excellent yield of manure, which can be used for agricultural purposes. So, thank you for listening to me.